28 anglers.
Awesome!
14 boats.
Yes!
9 nations.
No way.
6 days. One target fish.
That was a monster.
And one trophy. YPC Bass 2023 is brought to you by Bay Eins Boat Center. We build your boat. Hardy Rise, feel the difference. And Lure Drop, Christmas every month.
Hello everybody and welcome to Italy again. We are back in Bolsena, where the YPC Bass champions Team LX with Mark Pachowski and Mattia De Santo will try to defend this beautiful trophy. But it's gonna be a tough one for several reasons. Everybody has learned from season one. Lures, spots, techniques. We have more teams in the field. We have real professional bass fishermen participating. And we have some interesting underdogs who can also be very dangerous as soon as they find out the trick to get the big ones. YPC 2023, it's on.
Hi guys, my name is Jonathan Faila, and I'm happy to lead you through the second season of the YPC Bass, and we'll start by presenting the location, tournament mode, rules, participating teams, and the anglers of Group A, who we will see in action today. As Tony mentioned in the intro, the YPC Bass 2023 takes place at Lake Bolsena, which is a beautiful volcanic lake located around 100 kilometers northwest of the Italian capital, Rome. There are 14 teams participating, which have been divided into two groups of 7. In Group A, we have the fishing equipment brands 13 Fishing, Abu Garcia, Moby Soft Baits, Weston, Zeck, the Austrian distributor for Japanese fishing brands Redfin, and the Swedish tackle distributor Catch With Care. In Group B, we find the fishing tackle manufacturer Ilex and LMAB, so the defending champion and the vice champion of 2022. Mullix, Hardy Rise, Savage Gear, Stroft, and the German boat manufacturer and distributor Bay Eins Boat Center. Both groups fish 2 days each. The 4 teams with the highest overall weight of each group make the cut to the semi-finals, where then 4 of 8 teams will qualify for the finals. Semi-finals and finals are just 1 day of fishing each. In the group stage, the teams have 16 hours to catch 10 sizable fish in total. 2 of them need to be caught on topwater lures to make a full card. The minimum weight is 500 grams. Fish under that limit don't count, as well as fish pulled out with the line. This rule should motivate the anglers to treat the fish correctly and use a landing net or do a proper hand landing. In the semi-finals and finals, 5 fish, including 1 topwater catch, can be brought onto the leaderboard. There are only artificial baits allowed, and it is a cast-only tournament, which means that trolling is forbidden. Like last year and in the YPC boat, live technology fish finders are only allowed for 1 hour per day and have to be switched off for the rest of the day. The anglers can decide themselves when they want to start what we call their power hour. Today we show you the first half of day one in Group A. Now it's time to introduce the teams and their anglers. 13 Fishing is a young bass fishing brand from the United States of America. They sent the same anglers to the YPC Bass as last year. The Austrian Clemens Frank, who is currently studying in Vienna, knows Lake Bolsena very well and has quite a large bass fishing knowledge despite his young age. Marcel Weigel, fishing guide from Germany, is mainly a pike, perch and zander angler, but his performance in the last season and during training was quite impressive. Let's see if they can make the finals this year. Abu Garcia was founded in Sweden back in 1921 and is without a doubt one of the most known fishing tackle brands worldwide. The Italian Alessandro Villari, fishing guide on Lake Bolsena, has lots of skills in bass fishing. Furthermore, Alessandro has quite a bit of tournament experience. For example, he was elite tournament trail champion in 2007. Last year, Alessandro and his partner were the favored team to win the cup, but they surprisingly missed the finals. They caught several big fish, but in the end, not enough keepers. This year, Alessandro has probably an even stronger partner on his boat. Maybe you already heard about it, and yes, it's true. Mike Iaconelli, one of the most successful professional bass anglers in the world, came over to fish the YPC bass. We will probably be able to see his skills within the next videos. But let's drop some facts anyway. The US American from New Jersey has been a full-time tournament angler for 25 years. He has won more than $3 million prize money during his career and won the biggest titles in bass fishing, like the Bassmaster Classics in 2003 or the Angler of the Year Award in 2006. We are super excited to see if someone can beat the combination of a local guide and one of the best bass anglers worldwide. Moby Soft Baits is a lure manufacturer producing environmentally friendly lures in Germany. One of the owners will compete himself, Johannes Otto, a passionate pike and perch angler who just finished 15th in the prestigious Lure Masters tournament, but has almost zero bass fishing experience. His teammate Benedikt Götzfried from southern Germany is an experienced bass angler. He has been specializing in topwater fishing for many years, which could be a decent advantage regarding the rules of this competition. Redfin is an Austrian company distributing high-end Japanese fishing brands such as Hayabusa, Gancraft, and 10 Feet Under. Their owner, Martin Neumann, participated last year, but he and his partner didn't really find the big fish during the YPC Bass 22. This year, Martin can not only count on the performance of a much faster boat, he has a Japanese fishing superstar at his side as well. Ken Iobe has been fishing in the US Bassmaster Series for 13 years now and has already won silver and bronze medals. Ken, who has a huge following in his home country, Japan, is not only a bass pro, but also a well-known lure designer for his own brand, 10 Feet Under, as well as other big brands like Shimano. Let's see if the changes in the Redfin team will have a big impact on this year's outcome. Another new team in the YPC Bass is the Swedish tackle distributor Catch With Care, who take part with two Dutchmen. Evert Ostam has participated in tons of predatory fishing competitions and has also won two big ones, Perch Pro 7 and the European Fishing League in 2022. One of his teammates in this tournament was his friend and YPC Bass partner, Lex Peters. So, both Evert and Lex are successful predatory tournament anglers, but they have hardly fished for bass before, never fished a bass competition, and have never been on Bolsena before the start of the training. Same story for Daniel Nielsen, who takes part from Westin, a famous Danish fishing tackle brand. The Swedish fishing star, who is a super strong tournament angler when it comes to pike fishing, has no bass fishing experience and has never fished this lake before. Since his flight got canceled, he had almost zero training, but luckily the facts about his partner are more encouraging. Frenchman Alexandre Bigot is an experienced bass angler. He almost made the finals last year and caught some big bass in training. Let's see how they perform together in the tournament. The seventh team of the group, Team Zeck, a German fishing tackle company, is a pretty promising one, at least in terms of entertainment, since we have two very different characters together in one boat. Johannes Dietl's nickname in Germany is Boschpapst, which means the Pope of Perch. And this name is well deserved. Not only has he caught millions of perch, he probably developed the most scientific and technical approach to perch fishing in Germany. He loves bass fishing, and his various perch fishing skills help him to be very good at it. But it's the first bass fishing tournament for the winner of the World Predator Classics in 2017. His teammate Markus Eule is the owner of a fishing camp in Italy, a YouTube star in Germany, but his main target fish always used to be catfish. He's certainly not a finesse angler, but you should still not underestimate him. In the YPC Bank for Pike, Perch and Zander, Marcus could make it to the semi-finals. So watch out for the newcomers team Zeck with Dietl and Eule. Since we want the teams to be able to fish both morning and evening hours, the plan is to start late on the first day and early on the second. That was a lot of information. Let the teams finally start fishing.
I think the weather is perfect. We have some little wind on the water. It's always good for the fish to be active. We have a plan. And I think we're gonna do it.
We're gonna nail it.
I think we have good chance to get a big one.
Yeah. We are 200 pounds.
2 pound person. 100 and 200 person. Yeah.
Yesterday in the interviews I told that we have small goals, but ambition ones. And one is to catch the first fish of the competition, so we won't drive so far.
Ready?
Start, have an awesome fishing day, catch a lot of big ones, and I hope you enjoy it.
That's the plan for today, and we just have a short ride to our first spot, and here we go.
Yeah, here we go, catch some big ones.
Yes.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Good luck today, good luck. Really short run this morning. Start it not far from the ramp, so that's nice. We get fishing very quick, so that's good. We've got a pretty good strategy today where we're going to be fishing shallow and deep. So this is a shallow spot. How many meters?
Around 3.5.
3-4 meters. And we're power fishing. We're using big baits. Big baits. Big line, big rods, but at some point today we're gonna change and we're gonna switch to deep water. And when we get deep, we'll use a little more finesse. So, little power, little finesse. Hopefully that's the right strategy to advance.
Abu Garcia is starting with bigger lures in a shallow area. Redfin seems to have a similar idea for their first spot.
Let's go. I'm using a Titan from Gangcraft.
And I'm using a screw bait also from Gangcraft. And so have the first cast.
Good morning, guys. Welcome to the first episode YPC Bass 2023. We're super stoked to be back. It's gonna be an amazing event. We have some new tactics, some new spots, some old spots. We're very excited.
We have a good time in the training. And now the first spot, we try to fish with power fishing. Crankbaits and jerkbaits.
We will see what's gonna happen.
Yeah.
Stay tuned and wish us luck.
Hey guys, welcome to YPC Bass 23. We are Team Weston. We are ready to fight. And this year, I have my new teammate and I will let him introduce himself.
Yeah, my name is Daniel Nilsson. I'm normally a predatory fishery in Sweden. I fish for pike, perch and sander. So bass is completely new for me. I started fishing bass yesterday, but the differences are many, but there's also many similarities to the stuff I'm used to fishing. And I want to say it's a complete honor to be in a competition against all these good bass anglers, so many nice people, and it's super nice to be here, and I'm honored for Hechtum Bars having me. So our first spot that we've chosen is a place where the wind has been pushing for a couple of days. It's a shallow area, we have some weed beds, and we caught really nice bass here yesterday on training. It's good because we have a super small boat, so we're not the fastest, but we only have 13 fishing close by. Otherwise, now I see another fast boat coming, but it was good for us to be alone here and see what we can do. We need to get a couple of fish in the boat, feel comfortable, and we'll see what happens. I mean, fishing is fishing, anything can happen.
Yeah, fish. Net, net, net. Het is al gelijk een maatje. Oh fuck. Geef maar. Oké, okay, first spot. In training this spot was for us really successful. We fished this spot with crankbaits and they went crazy for it. We just arrived and we were not even ready and I already took a fish. It jumped off just in front of the net. But yeah, our hopes is for this spot. In pre-fishing, we didn't see anybody fish here. So that's for us even more motivation for this spot, because it's really like left alone on a high pressured lake like this. And yeah, we have high hopes to fill the cart in this lake. So yeah, support us and thumbs up for us. Team Catch With Care.
Now I'm using the search baits, quanks or shadow bait now in the tree. And I hope so we can catch the first keeper.
Very small one. Had a small follower and I already had a good contact. Fifth cast now. Maybe the sixth. Oh, contact again. Trying to catch them with a jerk bait over the weeds. This one was working in the training very well. So quite confident that I can present the first fish soon.
In the beginning, there are big similarities between the seven boats. All teams start with hard baits or metal lures, trying to find fish in shallow water as quickly as possible. It's a sunny day, but there's a bit of wind on the lake, which should definitely help power fishing styles. Let's see who will get the first fish on the board.
Good one. It's not a good one. I think it's a keeper. Maybe.
Yes. That's a keeper. Boom! This is a keeper, man.
Hopefully it's zeroed 660 grams.
Nice catch, nice catch.
I tried with top water.
Okay. That'd be nice to get those out of the way, huh? Catch two on top water real quick, or one would be nice.
I'm using a little chopper. It's easy.
Oh, got it! Big, big! Top water fish. What side? Oh. Good, good. Slow, slow, slow.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah! 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 Okay, not a big one, but that is top water fish. Very important in our strategy is to catch a top water fish, and got that done right away. Here's our weight, eight, nine.
Okay.
Okay, number one.
Yo, Tim, wow.
Number one.
Yeah!
Yes! Alessandro!
Yo!
Perfecto! Perfect!
Yeah. The first of many.
Yes, first fish in the house.
55.
First fish. 5.5?
Yeah. The lake liner, vond ik.
Yeah. Yeah. No. Quick. I missed the bite. Felt like a good fish, but you can't tell because I'm jerking very aggressively. So I'm pulling really hard, and when you hit a fish like that, always feels big.
Fish on.
Oh.
Oh. No, it went off.
It went.
Yeah.
Was it a nice fish?
Yeah, not that big, I think, but he went through the weeds and.
Good sign.
Yeah, yeah.
Good sign. Cool, on the outside of the weed bed.
Probably a bass cruising.
Keeper?
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Don't do gentle, don't do gentle.
All right, yeah, yeah, yeah. Good job, man.
Good job, man.
Number one keeper.
Number one keeper.
Yeah.
0.79. Okay, perfect. First pass.
You got one.
Got it.
Yeah, good job, man.
What do you think? How many kilos we can catch?
Maybe. Yeah, 10 to 50.
10 to 50?
Yeah, 12 to 50.
Got one. Got
little guy.
Yeah, but he's a keeper. For sure. Got it. Come on. Come on. Got it.
Woo!
Good job, Cam.
Yeah.
Okay, put it on. It's your fish. 0.89.
Close to 900.
Yeah, super okay. Good job, Ken. Yeah.
Thank you. Go home. Bye bye.
First five sizable fish caught. Time for the first leaderboard. Redfin takes the lead with two decent bass, followed by Abu Garcia, who have the biggest and the only topwater fish so far. SEC and CWC are currently on 3 and 4, with one keeper each. The rest, including Team Moby, are still chasing their first points.
So I start with the stick bait. My plan is the topwater fish, the big topwater fish. But I don't know, maybe I switch to the popper soon, because I figured out that a little bit waves and the popper often works better together. So, but just a couple of casts with the stick, left, right. You have to twitch it, make a little bit of noise on the surface. Fish a lure of 9.5 centimeters. It's a Kinky Stick Junior made by me, Topwater Productions. And yeah, maybe it works. And if it doesn't work, the popper is my second choice.
It's not gonna be a keeper and definitely not gonna be enough to win anything, but still, fish are active. We have some action on the spot and now we just have to try to catch a bigger one. Small adjustment for the tactics. There's some pretty good weed that we marked on the graph. I'm gonna change to Jighead Wacky with the bubble butt. What are you gonna do?
Yeah, I fish with a topwater lure. The new Rapala Precision Extreme Pencil.
The reason for the change now is that we don't want to spook the fish with big power fishing and a running engine. So we hit the spot lock and make long casts to the spot. And after that, we're going to go over it again with the power baits so that we might get the ones that didn't react to the wacky, but still, we're going to try our best to finesse them out of the reef.
Keeper, yeah. 6-1. Fish.
Oh, big one.
Big one?
Yeah.
Ready.
I got it!
Yes!
That's big one.
Okay, this is yours.
Okay. You got it.
Ten.
The big one. This is a beautiful Borsena fish with chitin from Gangcrafter. Woo! That's beautiful. Beautiful fish.
1.7, I think. Yeah.
Oh! Thank you. Go home. All right.
With two smaller keepers, Abu Garcia has conquered the top of the table. But Ken Iobe strikes back. 1.7 kilos. This is the biggest fish of the tournament so far. And those fish, of course, are super helpful when you fight for the next round. Team 13 Fishing notices this catch pretty quickly.
The first 1 kilo plus fish is in the app. Team Redfin, 1.7. It's a very, very strong fish for the first hour here in the competition.
Very well done, Ken. We expected you to be strong though, but don't be too strong. Yeah. Yeah, passed.
Okay.
Yeah. Very good fish.
Good fish.
Schnell.
Ooh! Yes!
In the boat! Boom!
Perfect.
See, congratulating other guys is good mojo for this.
Yeah.
Very good fish. That actually could be a kilo fish. Came on the Storm Arashi jerk bait. And I'm using a high gear ratio reel, short rod, and just jerking as hard as I can, actually. Good fish. 1.21. First good fish, Team 13 Fishing. Beautiful bass on a jerk bait. He goes back.
Back in the game.
Send us your brothers and sisters. Jawohl!
Exklusive Sonderfarben, brandheiße Neuheiten, teilweise schon vor der Markteinführung, erprobte Klassiker, passendes Zubehör, wertvolle Expertentipps, Anwendungsempfehlungen per Flyer und Video, eine Chance auf den Monatsjackpot, nützliche Goodies und einen riesigen Preisvorteil. All das gibt es per Luredrop-Abo monatlich zu dir nach Hause geliefert. Check www.luredrop.de und werde auch du ein glücklicher Luredropper. Luredrop. Christmas every month.
A little bigger, that one's gonna keep. That's 6.4.
Watch out! I get in the zone!
6.8?
Big.
bass. Team, wow!
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 The Lord just fell out!
Wow! Wow! Gigante!
Gigante!
Gigante! That is the time we're looking for right there. That's the kind to do very well in this competition. Better than average fish, almost 4 pounds US. So let's see what it is on our Jack Armstrong pedometer here. Let's see. 146?
Yes.
Okay, 146.
Yeah!
I'm nervous and I didn't even catch a fish.
After 13 fishing's decent keeper, Abu has a 3-fish streak and climbs to the top of the board. They already have 6 of 10 keepers and are happy with their choice of spot.
Now it gives me confidence there's big ones here. Before I was worried, no big ones. Now you see a big one, you say, oh, good, okay.
Believe me.
I do. When you're fishing flats like this, they could be anywhere on the flat. It's not a specific spot, you know? So really have to kind of 360 cast, 360 degrees. Since we're in Italy, I call it cutting the pizza. We gotta slice it up. We gotta slice the pizza out here.
Although Team SEC are not using the most state-of-the-art navigational technology, Johannes and Marcus still somehow seem to arrive at their desired spot.
This is a very sweet spot. There we have stones and the shoreline goes a little bit deeper into the lake. And we are at the drop-off now. There's some weeds at the ground, at the bottom. And yeah, we are trying to scan this one with a Texas rig. Me and Marcus is casting crankbaits. What did you contact?
Weed? I think so, yes.
Well. He's always in contact with the weed. He's looking for the weed.
We need more weed.
Oh, fish.
Yeah, fish?
Yeah.
F-ing legend.
Super cool. We're fishing fast techniques. Oh, that's a big death.
Oh, no way.
It's my fault. I took the rod up because I was in the weed.
No way. That was a really big fish.
Oh, shit.
That was the biggest one we've seen this far.
Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Oh, my God.
Oh, man, that really sucks. That was a big bass.
That was a monster. I'm stupid.
Oh, shit. We fished fast techniques, had no bites, barely. Put on the wacky first cast, boom. Huge fish.
Yeah. The problem is that there is a big weed bed in front of us. I caught him on the other side of the weed bed. He went into, and the big fish here are really specialists to do that. As soon as you hook up, you hook them, they go straight in the weed bed.
Dude, so cast again.
I put my rod up to make the fish above the weeds, and I was not fast enough to put it down after. He made a jump, and hook off.
That was a big fish.
Oh, yeah, f***ing hell, that's exactly what we needed.
Then at least we know they're here. Ah, that was both a really good and a really bad start to the day.
Oh my God.
That was big.
That was big.
Yeah, we caught a 1.8 kilogram fish here yesterday and this was way, way bigger.
Too bad for Weston to lose this lunker. And they are not the only ones with heavily bending rods around.
Yeah. Good fish. I'm with you. I'm with you. And a big one. And a big one. Let's see.
And a big one. Woohoo!
Yes! Finally. Hey.
Look at this fish!
How much? How much is it?
1.5. Yeah, it's
159.
159. Astro Vibes is killing it again.
Gonna release it?
Yeah, fish. Oh, huge strike, Lex.
Bye bye.
Big one! Big one! Oh god! Oh my god! Oh, please come in the boat! Oh! Come on! Yeah! 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 Yeah!
I got a pretty fish. How pretty that fish is. 176.
Yes.
Yeah! 176. Yes.
I told ya. This is the right place.
It's the biggest fish of the day so far, which makes Ike totally freak out. But Abu are not the only team catching big fish. CWC get a lunker as well and climb to the third place in the rankings.
Hell yeah. Shallow, shallow. All right, you heard me talking earlier about when you're fishing flats, expansive flats, to cut the pizza 360, because it's not one spot, it could be anywhere on this flat, so it's very important to cut the pizza, slice it up. Think they called the cops?
Who?
Me screaming?
No.
Bite, bite, small. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, 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 oh. Good fish, good fish. Net, net, net.
Yeah.
Very good fish.
Okay, yeah, yeah. Yes, yes, yes!
Yes.
1 kilo. It's a 1 kilo fish.
Whoo! Boom! Next good fish on the jerkbait. They're smashing them. Once again, the Samarashi. Super good jerkbait. 0.9.
Yeah.
0.9, next fish close to a kilo.
Good job, Clemens.
Yeah, great. We're getting great. Somewhere. He goes back. Back in the water. Ciao, my friend. This pattern is so strong. We are really targeting especially bigger fish. I mean, that wasn't a huge one, but the average size is very good.
Almost. I caught this nice bass on a popper because I figured out while the waves are coming, the popper is much better sometimes. And yeah, he ate my lure. It was nice. The first catch of the day. So now we caught already the small ones. Let's catch the big ones right now. But I'm happy with the first bass for my tournament day on Lago di Bolsena. Bye bye, Biggie. Come back soon or in a couple of years. Popper fishing for me here for the Bolsena black bass is most of the time it's slow fishing. Just pop it once or twice, let it sit a little bit, pop it another time, and while I'm popping I pull my rod down, so especially in the waves it's much more easy and if you pull it down. But sometimes if there's no wind I also pull the twitches up, because I don't know, the popper makes a little bit of different sound then. But in the waves it's not that easy then is it is without waves. So let's see, figure it out.
Yeah, it's okay.
With
one more throw again.
Other side,
yeah,
or
yeah, yeah.
To the other spot.
Yeah, same spot.
This spot or moving?
Yeah, moving.
Okay.
We need a big seven fish more.
Yeah, seven more. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go.
important key spot for us because there is a special grass in a very small spot, and there hide a lot of big bass. Around there is grass as well, yes, but not the correct one. But who is the correct one is a little bit secret.
It'd be secret.
Equal, yep. Yeah.
Pass.
Good one.
Wait,
careful. I'll go back. Oh my gosh. Oh,
it's okay.
I can bring him out.
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah. Really good one.
Yeah, a little good one. Yeah,
it's a good one.
Don't do that.
You got it?
Oh my god!
That's a big one! Oh my god.
Oh, 2 kilo, I think.
Oh, wait, careful. I think it's my new personal best. Yeah, it's my personal best for sure. Oh my god, this is a big one. A really good
bass.
Look at this mouse.
Close to 2 kilo. 75.
Okay.
Good job, man. Yeah. Good job,
got
man.
A big one. Yeah. The second big bass in boat.
Yeah.
So it's really
That's
good.
Awesome.
Oh, the really belly.
Yeah. Looks like you.
Yeah. Thank you for the perfect practice. Yeah. This is awesome.
Right.
Yeah. And now we have to go back to the water. Perfect. I'm happy.
No, we're happy.
Yes, I can. So good.
Seems like Martin found the right grass. In any case, his new personal best is a really valuable fish for Team Redfin and makes him very happy.
The lure was from the Gangcraft.
Screw bait. With Gangcraft?
Yes. Yeah. And the magic with this bait is super slow spinning.
Yeah.
That's the secret of the bait. Perfect. Yeah. Let me cast this.
Got one.
Yeah, big one.
Got
yeah.
one. Breathe. Don't jump. Our little guys.
Little guys?
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe 500 fish.
So, just.
I don't know, maybe 45.
Yeah, we will try.
Yeah.
Really? For sure, really? It's a keeper, yeah, for sure.
Yay.
It's 0.65.
Bye-bye.
Psst. Wir feiern den Start in die YPC-Saison 2023. Einfach im Shop Waren im Wert von mindestens 50 Euro in den Warenkorb legen, anschließend die Scale hinzufügen, den Code Hashtag YPCSeason23 eingeben und den Kauf abschließen. Schon ist die Scale geschenkt. Nur vom 27. bis zum 30. Januar auf hechtundbarsch.de.
Come on.
Oh.
Never even had them on for half a second. That was a good one. Yep. It's gonna.
You see your chatterbait.
Yeah. It hit your nuts. Chatterbait came back and hit Alessandro right in the balls, square in the nuts. Yeah, that was unfortunate. That was a good one, but you know the thing about it is, if I sit here and get all pissed off and mad and angry, I let it ruin my day. You just gotta let it roll off you, you know? I gotta let it roll off, yeah. I gotta believe that there'll be more opportunities, you know?
It's a keeper.
5-5.
Big one. Oh, giant.
Giant.
Oh my God, giant.
Giant.
Oh my God.
Slow, 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 slow.
Slow.
Slow, take time.
Ah! Ah! Easy. Easy.
God, giant. Trailer hook. All right, everybody, look real quick. This is a good lesson if you're watching at home. This is a Mollick spinnerbait, okay? A lot of people know this bladed bait, but I want you to look where it's hooked. There's the main hook. You see the main hook? Look at that. Alessandro got him on the trailer hook. In open water, when the cover allows you, always, always use a trailer hook. If he wasn't throwing that trailer hook, we would not have caught that fish.
Yeah.
That's as big as they get, you know?
Biggest fish of the day. I hope.
It's biggest fish of the day.
I hope.
I'm like dead-eyed Dick. I can tell you right now.
178.
178.
178.
178.
Good job.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
You're the man. Very happy to catch some big one for you. Go.
Yeah. Nice fish.
Pull it hard.
Yeah, saw that.
Many fish get caught, but no changes in the leaderboard. Apu Garcia just caught the best fish of the day, which made them already cross the 8-kilo mark. Redfin is close to 6 kilos now. CWC still third with less than 3 kilos. 13 Fishing got their third keeper and remained fourth. No fish for Zek for a while, and still no keeper for Moby and Weston today.
Ah, f***.
Sorry. Children. Those fish, it was, I had a third tap tap, but the fish doesn't stay on. Maybe these fish are really, really shy lankers. So we hold this spot a little bit longer. At least until I catch one of those oh! Beauties.
Small nibbles on the bait. That can be small fish. Johannes thinks it could be shy but big fish. Is he right?
It's a whopper. Oh man, it's a really, 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 it's a giant. Yes, man.
Baby.
Yeah.
Boom. This is what we need. Over two.
It's the first 4-pounder, you know?
You are a hero. You are a hero.
Come on.
What a giant.
What a quagga. And what a nice color.
Amazing.
Oh. Yes.
Yes. Baby.
2-2-5.
He was right. Good decision to stay at the spot because this is a new YPC bass record. 2.25 kilos makes Team Zek jump to third place, and the other competitors congratulate them for this awesome catch.
Ooh, Joan, 2.25.
2.25? That's a giant. Is that a bass or a carp?
Cool. 225, congrats, Johannes. Huge fish, man. Yeah, great.
It's cool to see, but because competition fishing in this style, even though like we're having a super struggle today, it's always possible to catch fish. Any YouTube production you watch, some teams may be struggling, but there's always at least one team catching fish. So that means you can always catch fish.
Yeah,
and that's the cool thing about competition fishing. It shows. Yeah.
And depending on our spots as well, you know, it can be maybe our spots were better in the afternoon. And
yeah, because yesterday we fished the afternoon.
Yeah, for sure. And like last year with my teammate, hi Tommy, by the way,
yeah.
We were more from the afternoon, and it seemed that with Daniel, Westin boys are definitely also from the afternoon.
Yeah.
So we will make it better in the afternoon.
Yeah, we're late bloomers.
Yeah.
2.25, biggest fish of YPC Bass 1 and 2. What the f***? Johannes, congratulations. Amazing
great,
fish.
Great, Johannes. Great. Good job, man.
Yeah. But not so good for us. So we have to make a move now.
Yeah.
Fishing got slow at our spot, so we're going to change tactics and...
We go out?
Yeah, we're going to go offshore and see if they're reacting to drop shots better than they are to our heartbeats right now. We'll see. Let's go.
13 Fishing is changing their spot, and Team Moby is trying out a new area as well.
So, new spot, and hopefully in the next few minutes we get someone. And can something show into the camera. We will see.
So let's start fishing here, or?
Yes.
Okay, tight lines to you. Now we have to catch one.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Oh, sorry, that's bullshit. Okay, that's bullshit. I'm so sorry.
Still there.
Okay. Oh, not that way. Sorry, Hannes.
No.
Okay. I'm so sorry for that.
That should. Oh, shouldn't happen again. Yes.
Maybe.
Oh no!
Voice, see me.
Oh yeah! That's a lanka. That's a 2-kilo fish almost. Woohoo! To our spot and it works.
Yes.
What an awesome fish, my friend.
Your personal best. That's my
new personal best. We will see how big it is.
1.85. Yeah. Take your awesome fish.
New personal best.
Yeah. Woo, Hannes, you did it.
Yes.
The new spot works immediately. The tangling with Bene's lure doesn't stop Johannes from bringing the fish into the net. First bass for Moby, and it's a huge one.
My favorite Rakeshet in the black color with golden pigs. It's about 10 centimeters long, and you know it, it's quite tough and brings good black bass. I will take another one on this lure.
Johannes, the first keeper, the biggest fish of the day. I think we need more weed. All the fish are in the weed. And lots of anglers.
It's a fish, yeah, a small fish.
Yeah, that could be a keeper.
Boo! I've never been so happy with a small band.
Yo,
Yes! It's gone. It was a real big fish. Oh man.
Deep of a leg, 6.3. Not the biggest fish.
Cinque, quattro.
Hombre, keeper. Come up, guy, come up.
Oh, good job, man.
Yeah.
Nice three.
Big one. Big one.
Okay.
Yeah, big one, big one.
Oh, big one. Giant, giant.
Oh, take your time. Slow, slow.
Yes.
Good one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Trick of the day. You know, windy. Spinner bait. One time again. The saver. The trailer hook. Change the game. 1.31. Okay. Yeah.
Nice one.
The last bass of the first episode is another big fish for Alessandro. Abu Garcia gets their ninth fish on the board, while Redfin, Zek, and CWC can improve their board slightly, and Weston brings in their first keeper of the day. At the moment, it looks like Abu Garcia and Redfin have very good chances to advance to the next round. But there are four semi-final spots to fight for, and still 1.5 days to fish. Please leave us a like, comment, and subscribe to the channel to support us. Don't forget to tune in again next Sunday at 6 p.m. Central European Time. Until then, ciao!